In this video, I teach you a dry sump lubrication system for internal combustion engines. So we understand the various component of a dry sump lubrication systems and the working of dry sump lubrication system. So first we study the various component. So here you see, this is the image of the dry sump lubrication system. So here it is the engine crankcase where the oil is stored. It is known as a dry sump, and this dry sump is connected with the scavenging pump or oil pump. Then after, this is the filter. Here the name is not mentioned, but this is the filter and the oil. Next component is going to this supply tank, and from the supply tank again this one oil pump is provided. Then after, this oil coolers, and after the oil coolers, the oil is supplied to the various component of the IC engines where the lubrication is required. So next we understand the working of dry sump lubrication system. Okay, so in a dry sump lubrication system, as shown in this figure, we already studied the various component. The oil from the sump. Oil from the sump means it is the engine crankcase. So here you see that it is the engine crankcase, and it is the dry sump is pumped to the separate storage tank. So first the oil is stored in engine crankcase. It is supplied to this supply tank. Okay, or it is also known as the separate storage tank, and this storage tank is outside the engine cylinder. So it is provided outside, not inside the engine. The oil from the sump is passes through the filter. Okay, so this oil from the sump, this is called as the dry sump, is passes through this filter. So here it is the filter, and here it is the scavenging pump. So first the oil from the dry sump is come inside this scavenging pump, then after it is supplied to this filter. And after this filter, it is supplied to the separate tank or a supply tank. It is provided outside the engine cylinder. So before moving ahead, I request to like the video, and if you don't subscribe the channels, then subscribe channels by pressing the subscribe buttons, and also visit the playlist for watching the various video related to mechanical engineering. Next is the function of the filter. Means function of this filter is to remove the abrasive particles from oil. Otherwise, if we not putting this filter, then what happen? The abrasive particles are going with the oil, and this abrasive particle is increase the wearing of the bearing surface and also deposit to the bearing surface. So life of the bearing is reduced if we not put the filter. If the filter become clogged, the filter bypass relief valve opens and permit the oil to the bypass filters. Means suppose there is some problem in a filters like the clog, then the oil is supplied to this filter bypass pressure relief valve. Okay, that is the lubrication is continuous. So that's why we require to clean the filter after some times. Otherwise, we are not clean the filters, then the some clog particles and abrasive particles are go to the bearings and the piston cylinders, and they increase the wear and tear of the engine components. Now oil from the storage or supply tank is pumped to the engine bearing and the cylinder through the oil coolers. So once the oil is passed from this filter, it is stored in here this supply tank, and after that the oil is supplied to the oil cooler through the oil pump, and the oil from the oil cooler is supplied to the various component and to the bearing of the engine. In this system, oil pressure is varies from 3 to 8 bar. Means oil supply to the bearing is pressure is 3 to 8 bar. The pressure relief valve is used to prevent excessive pressure build up after cold start of the engines. Now suppose the pressure is higher, that is oil coming out from this oil pump have a higher pressure than the 3 to 8 bar, then what happen? This pressure relief valve is open and the extra oil is supplied to again to the supply tank. So this is able to control the pressure of the oil coming out from the oil pump. The oil cooler reduces the temperature of oil. So we are talking about this oil cooler. So oil coming out from the pump is supplied to oil coolers. So from the name we can understand that it is used to cool the temperatures of the oil. So oil cooler reduces the temperature of oil. Therefore, dry sump lubricating system permits the use of thinner oils and result in increase the frictional resistance of the engine. Suppose we are not putting this cooler, then the temperature of the oil is higher. So this thickness and viscosities of the oil is reduced, so proper lubrication is not carried out. That's why we need to put this oil coolers to make the oil more thicker. Dry sump lubrication system is generally used for high capacity of the engine. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned and liked the video, subscribe the channels, comment on the video, and don't forget to share with your friends.